Ah, all right. So his white mage IQ'd for whatever would pop first, and the great Gubal library popped first, and it looks just the same as it did before. But there's extra monsters. Right, so for this one, let me grab my notepad. I took some notes of the videos I watched. All right. I'm White Mage. I'm not gonna watch the cutscenes. Oh, well, that'll probably be a little bit different, but I'm White Mage. We have a Paladin, Tank, Bard, and Summoner DPSs. Okay, we got boss number one. The demon actually jumps out of its home in hard mode. It turns it away. It's kind of, I don't know how to describe it. It's got like a big, kind of gross paper spiral tail thing. And then it will spawn in the center of the room. It's a very wide quickly. Item level 225. Vitality intelligence, sure. I remember I should probably use that. Vitality intelligence, sure. Yeah, item level 225 here. There's a couple kind of like slime monsters and a kind of demon, I guess you would call it. Kind of has wings to fly. What a great little bug. There is also a fire section here. You want to pull the monsters out of the fire so that you don't have to stand in it. There's a line attack. Like flaming horns that biblioclasts once again just don't. Anyway. Don't get hit by AoEs. Some little kind of like flying balls, black balls with the wings of another dude with swords. Trying to pull him down, actually. Sorry, bud. Bye. Dude's not great. And then, these tomes are, something like, they do a lot of damage as far as they're concerned. So you can either pull a small amount or a lot, but, stand on this little book, and it launches you to the upper realm, where you fight a liquid flame. This one's fun, from what I watched. Tank turns away. You can always do that as a tank on any fight ever, so. Well, so. How about I freeze for a second? Target two party members, myself and somebody else. You just kind of drop, you want to run away because of like three instances of like fire damage on the ground. You'll target another player with a tether. That player just wants to run as far away from as possible so that if the damage is mitigated, there's less damage than the part of the tether. AoE damage, group wide, unavoidable. It gets worse if you get attacked. Now he's a liquid flame, so I want to run to a fire, because I got a fire token above my head. Well, he's hand mode, so he's like a hand, fiery hand. What I hear is, if he were turning into an orb instead, kind of like a fire tornado, there's a charge mechanic. He shows himself as a particular charge. And if you are same charge, you want to stand near him to get bumped away. If you are opposite charge, you want to get away from him towards the edge of this fire circle. So you get bumped closer, but not into the fire in either case. And yeah, the flame hand is down. Level 225. Ooh, tanks? Fuck, sure, yeah. Sure, vitality, intelligence, sure. Red Mage might be able to use it. If not, I can sell it. Greed, it's greed because it's not my current class, so. There's a free company meeting because apparently we're having a merger. Some Borogos join the fun. Then stop at this kill. Otherwise, I'm mitigating the amount of time that you have to take damage from several buttons. That's why I put my down. Alright. We want to target the Servitor first. Thank you. that's just what the guide said. The guide said, like, if you kill the Surfer first, then the Magus, then the, Scribe. That's how you mitigate the most damage. Also a cutscene, so it shouldn't be a problem. 6 seconds, five, yeah, we're fine. Okay, the cutscene. We've got a large circular room, books, just tons of shelves, up, 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 and up, and up. Actually, only maybe like three levels of shelves. Apparently, but books all over. And there is a chair. It's like a winged chair with kind of an owl head. Has some books and stuff. This one is supposed to be fun there. So, let's go. You're unwelcome here. This is no, get your thirst for knowledge. Bring me the last time I would have to die. Alright, we drop some books around the room. They just have AoEs. Them, but they leave levitation kind of area. You want to get levitation, you can reduce the damage from quake on the properties of quake. Next up, people turn to two of the books called checkout. Books down, two of them will be shadow, two of them will be blue. You want to get the meteor cast that's sitting behind a boulder, but put the boulder between yourself and the behemoth. But yeah, you also avoid the... Oh, so okay, here. As part of the quest, a book levitates itself from a nearby chair, couch kind of thing. And commend you. There we go. Alright, and then there's a book on the ground. Yeah, I did that wrong, so... I don't know what you do for darkness. You might just absorb it, I guess? Tornadoes, I know you stand in the darkness, from what I remember from the video. And then imps, I thought you ran into the blue circles to avoid that. Whatever. Did I get the book? I did. Okay, cool. That's going to be the end of this video. Yeah, that was the Great Gubal Library on Hard. I'm going to make sure I remove that from my possibilities here. And yeah, I'll see you for the next video. Probably, yeah, I'll do another one. So, see you next time.